Hey everyone, I got a fun little article here for you. Chemtrails proof. Chemtrails to be declared real after scientists found aerosols can save ozone layer. Now I have done a video on another article that scientists have screwed up the earth by using chemtrails. I will post that video in the link below. And what it describes is that they are in a little bit of a paradox right now. And what they did was, over the years of using chemtrails for over 50 years, they now say that they used chemtrails to try to cool off the earth. However, if they continue using massive amounts of chemtrails, they could cool the earth off too much that it could cause another ice age. And if they suddenly, abruptly stop using chemtrails, it could heat up the earth and rebound and make the earth so hot that eventually it could be destroyed. What they have done to us and everybody else on their scientific garbage and their fake global warming absurdities have ultimately caused the greatest failure of humanity. However, they will continue the lie to make you feel safe while they're still using chemtrails. And they will always be using chemtrails because they are stuck. They cannot return to not using chemtrails, and it cannot massively spray chemtrails. So they absolutely have to continue the chemtrail program, or else we will face extinction. This has something to do with why scientists are starting to tell you we need to leave the earth in 100 years or face extinction, because of the things that they have done. So the article starts, a team of Harvard scientists has offered a new hope to the worsening global warming through their studies on the so-called chemtrails. Now, we wouldn't have global warming if they would stop screwing off with Antarctica. Antarctica is a place of great natural resources. All you have to do is listen to Admiral Byrd. Admiral Byrd was the last explorer because he went to the edges of the earth. And he describes it very well. There are places under the ice that have so many resources that we can start another civilization. So the idea of chemtrails was part of a conspiracy theory that world governments have been spraying chemicals into the air. This program, according to some theories, was kept from public eyes for several highly sensitive reasons. Chemtrails for real? For the first time, a credible group of scientists has provided substantial science-backed evidence to prove the existence of chemtrails. Not only did the scientists provide evidences, they also confirmed that this could be our saving grace against global warming. What they mean is saving grace from themselves. Because they have to tell you the truth now. They have to let you know that they must do this or face the consequences. And they will blame global warming. But global warming is caused by the scientists. So this, in general, is nothing more than circular reasoning and getting you to believe that they did nothing wrong. Researchers from Harvard, John A. Paulson School of Engineering and Applied Sciences announced a new aerosol they have discovered, which could be useful in geoengineering, the Harvard Gazette reported. Now, if they discovered a new aerosol that will be useful in geoengineering. Now understand that statement. That means that geoengineering has been going on forever because they're adding a newly discovered aerosol to add in to geoengineering. So in the next few years, this will get very interesting. Watch how many people get sick from this new aerosol. Are you prepared for it? This aerosol could help heal the thinning ozone layer from further deterioration without causing more damage to it. The ozone layer protects the Earth from harmful ultraviolet radiation. Useful in geoengineering, Harvard professor David Keith, who is also the main author of the study, said their new discovery could help revolutionize the field of geoengineering. Understand this. This has been going on for so freaking long that you're insane to believe that this is not happening. The study was published in the Journal of Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences and Solar Geoengineering Research. Introducing sulfuric acid into the atmosphere has been the only idea that had any serious traction until now. They want to believe that nothing is happening in this field of geoengineering, when in fact they will tell you straight up, scientists themselves, "Hey man, this is a very good idea. Let's throw this aerosol in the air and hope to God it helps the earth." not even thinking, that's going to fall back down to the ground, kill all the crops, kill all the animals, and cause problems for humans. They don't care about you. They love their research. Science has become their god. This research is a turning point and an important step in analyzing and reducing certain risks of solar geoengineering. Now understand this, solar geoengineering. Another form of geoengineering would be called cloud seeding. They have a bunch of chemicals in cloud seeding. Weather geoengineering. They believe that they can turn the weather into a weapon. The major agency that has provided the most weaponization for weather modification is NASA. NASA is a militarized space agency. It is created by the Air Force and Nazis. The study outlined what are the types of chemicals that should and should not be used in geoengineering. If not properly used, these chemicals could cause harm to the Earth's ozone layer. You know what? Forget about the ozone layer and causing harm to the ozone layer. How about causing harm to the biological structure of humanity, animals, and your food? So in the comments section below, let me know what you think. And as always, make sure to like and subscribe.